podcast. I am with the one and only Mr. Philip Defranco. Phil, how are you doing?
Yeah, Phil, he's the best. I'm good. I'm exhausted and tired, so I might be a bit crazy. So I apologize in advance.
I will just tap you on the head and wake you up. Just a little good. I'm gonna boop you on the nose. Boop.
I was like, don't touch it. You're just gonna get grease on your face.
So we have been surviving CES 2014. Phil, to stop by, say hello. We're gonna talk a little bit about the tech that's here. There's a ton of new things to see. There's cars, there's electronics, and there's one question everybody wants to know here at CES. You ready to be a dad?
Yes! Yes, actually, it's changed what I look at. From the first night on, I was like excited about monitors. I was like, that's cheap, it's easy, I can get it, I can look at it on my phone, sold. Where can I get it? And then little toys, like there was the Ozobot, couldn't look at it the same because I just imagined a small child choking on it. But no, I'm excited. I'm gonna mess him up, I think, in all the right ways. That's my goal, because you can't not mess him up.
I remember right before my son was born, I got a 3-month-old. I used to travel, I did bungee jumping, I used to think like a couple months before, like, is this gonna kill me what I'm gonna do? Like, do I wanna go on a plane? I'm gonna die. Like, I'm never gonna see my son again, and it's gonna be over, but it changes everything.
So, question, I heard this from like two separate people, and I didn't think this is a thing. Did your parents or do you plan on never traveling on the same plane as your significant, like with your wife?
So I'm paranoid. In all fairness, I'm paranoid, but no, I'm not that paranoid. I'm not like the president. Like, you can't put the president and the vice president in the same room.
That's the only other time I've heard that. And I was like, who's the kid going to travel with? No, like, who's he with?
I'm like, I'm crazy in my head, but I would never, like, other than video, I never say it out loud. Like, no, if we fly together, we're all going to die.
Yeah, together. It's a family unit.
So, kid coming. I know everybody wants to talk about technology, but kid coming.
Yep.
Any advice for would-be parents out there?
Oh, God. I'm like the most ill-equipped person. No, nothing. Just... roll with it. If I feel like if I was 100% terrified, that's not good. If I'm 100% confident, that's not good. I gotta understand it's a completely new thing. Everyone's gonna say that I'm probably doing the wrong thing, at least 70% of people. And I'm just gonna try and do a decent job and do the things that I think worked when I was a kid and not the other stuff.
That's fair. Don't listen to anybody.
Yeah,
that's the best advice I can give. Mothers, mother-in-law, everybody's got different opinions on how to do things. Yeah.
I was on a vacation with my fiance, and I said that I was drinking, and then everyone was like, make sure she doesn't drink. Like, what would make you think?
Like the drinking's going to cut into her serious drug use. that summarizes the internet. Like, there's a kernel of goodness in everything that they say, but it just comes across. It's like, no, stop it. Let me ask you about technology. So being more of a tech enthusiast than, like, you know, say a tech expert or someone who, you know, does it all the time, what have you seen here that's been interesting, and what can you not wait to get home into Defranco Manor?
Defranco Manor. A lot of like the bigger tech stuff I'm not super excited about. Like, I'm interested in like the Steam boxes. I'm interested in the Piston. I'm interested in that stuff because I like the idea of portable gaming where I always have the games I buy and I never have to go like, oh, well, all of those things that I spent hundreds of dollars on, they're gone. So I'm interested in that. A lot of it's the toys for me. I'm really interested in having the mini parrot because I'm not going to be the only person with one.
That thing looks incredible.
It's awesome. Did you ever get the drone 2.0?
Yeah, I broke the drone 2.0.
Exactly. Everyone's
broken
that. In
the first, like, 6 minutes.
Here, unlike the hobbyist market, there's the drone 2.0. There's that little one that flips now, which I'm not a big fan of. There's the mini, which now they have the wheels, which also serves as, like, the weird bumper. And then there was, like, the $1,200 one by Ghibli? I don't know. It's, like, almost a hobbyist drone.
Yeah.
And it's nice, but it's still $1,200.
Isn't it crazy that's a thing, a hobbyist drone? Dude. Like, we're in the... it's a hobbyist drone!
It's awesome. Are you kidding me? Like, I went out with Richard Ryan, the YouTuber Rated RR.
Of course, do you shoot stuff?
Yes, but he also...
I always picture him just like an arsenal all the time.
The first time I found out, drones were like... there was a huge hobbyist community. They like brought two guys out. They made their own drones. And then he dropped a bomb with it. And it was amazing. And I was like, it's also the most terrifying thing in the world to know that hobbyists can do that successfully.
Dude, Richard Ryan's a good guy. I remember he sent me an email when the new Galaxy S4 came out. The day he's like, hey, can you get me one? ... I want to shoot it.
Yes. All the tech. Just shoot it. I will also add the one thing I was excited about last time and then is amazing this time, Oculus Rift.
That got from incredible to ridiculously amazing overnight. Yeah, anti-motion stuff?
Yeah. I mean, I feel like it's what happens when it's like a really good idea, it's a really good setup in the beginning, and then you get, what is it, $76 million of funding?
Yeah.
And then you see what happens.
Something just got like, well, let's try this.
Yeah.
I mean, they came totally grassroots last year with like a, you know, barely working rig. I mean, and now to see a transition of a company and like the power of any social media help promote them, and now what they can do is ridiculous.
And I believe in it. I believe in using that with like a controller. What do you think about all these other companies trying to kind of jump on the coattails and flesh out the VR experience, whether it be with those straps, whether it be with like that running thing.
Every few years you see like, it was like, okay, Lawnmower Man's going to happen. Like,
right.
It's going to happen. We just dated ourselves a little bit, but okay, it's going to happen. Yeah. It's going to be here. And then it was like Virtual Boy.
Yes.
You're like, oh.
I saw pictures from like old school CES and I was like, oh, we're going to look that ridiculous.
It's exactly.
One day.
You're like the brand new Kung Fu game for Nintendo. You know, jump over Snake.
And Sony had that new visor thing. Well, the new visor thing.
Have you tried that?
Yeah. It's, I don't know. There's a lot of space underneath. I might have maybe not attached it, but I feel like if it was a full blackout experience, it's cool. But I'm like, I'm not wearing that outside of my house.
Would you hook up a PS4, Xbox One, and get some gaming on that? That seems
maybe.
Look at, it's like a 101-inch screen, I think, equivalent.
Yeah.
And so it's ridiculous.
It's interesting. I don't know. I'd be much more interested in playing an immersive thing with Oculus Rift. That setup. The reason I don't believe in the other VR stuff is. It's really expensive on top of everything. You always have to think about like what Joe Blow in his dorm is going to be able to do if he even wants to get up. I mean, they even, like, I was talking to the guys that, I want to say it's pre-OVR, and they made a just upper body version because people were like, we don't want to stand. Like, we don't want to move, but we want to be able to shoot stuff like this for some reason. I don't know. I'm a big believer in the controller is always going to be a thing. Yeah. It's an extension of the body right now. I don't need to wave at my TV.
So anything else here at the show that you think is a can't miss for people who can't, you know, aren't at the show? That
shoot.
You'd want them to know. What's the must-have Defranco item?
No, that has to be the Oculus Rift. Oh, I'm just trying to think. Everything else, I forget who said it. It's just, it's all evolutionary, not revolutionary. A lot of it is. And like integration of some technology into things that you wouldn't think.
Yeah.
I don't know. What do you have one? So maybe it'll help me out.
The curved displays are nice. But I think what didn't get any attention, at LG's booth, they have mirror displays that you turn off, it looks like a mirror, mm-hmm. and a clear display, it looks like a window, like any normal window. That's 10-point multi-touch. That to me was, I mean, incredible. That's like living Minority Report.
Right. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm finding myself very not, like, I'm interested in 4K, but I don't know if it's going to be the standard anytime soon.
Can you see a difference when you watch 1080p? I mean, is it that noticeable?
It's hard, right? Because we're here on the floor with specialized video that's meant to look good, right? It's same guys that back when there were cassette players, like they made special music so it sounded great. I don't know. It look like the curved when I am in that like perfect zone. It's beautiful. What that looks like when I'm watching regular TV or if for some reason I have something that can play 4K. Yeah, I mean I'm sure it'll be amazing, but I'm a guy that I watch things at 720p and I'm pretty content.
Yeah, it seems like trying to replicate that like standard def to high def. Like, remember the first time you watched like a football game
in
high def?
HD?
And it was like, it was ridiculous.
Yeah.
That's never going to happen again. I mean, like, that, like, jaw dropping.
Just in there.
I can see the grass.
Right. Well, because what? The next thing was supposed to be ESPN 3D, and then that channel went by.
It's funny to see how quickly 3D went, like.
Well, I'm glad that at least this year there are much fewer glasses-less 3D. Everyone, I mean, I know I get it, but it's so bad.
It's like a headache inducing.
Yeah.
The effect is minimal at best.
Yeah.
And there's no value.
It's a great concept, but I mean I'm a big fan of the glasses that are cheap. I think is that that might be Sony. I can't remember.
Yeah, I know Sony's got some, and LG's got the the passive technology. It's just
the passive, right?
It's like the same technology where kids with the baseball cards, like as you move them a little bit, the guy swings.
Right.
Yeah, just make sure you're right in the sweet spot. You can see it a little bit.
Yeah. As long as I can watch How to Train Your Dragon 3D, I'm happy.
How do you train your dragon?
In all the right ways.
Very careful.
I don't know what that means.
Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoy. Please leave the comments for me or Phil right down in my pants region. We'd love to hear what you guys have to say. Special thank you to Toyota for sponsoring our CES coverage.